current world. It really wasn't that bad. And also, like, you couldn't talk to your mother about it. It's like, oh, you have to do that. But now you can. So, a couple of days ago, I found the company, got the intellectual property going, you know, the trademarks, patents, all the stuff that both speakers talked about earlier that we've had to deal with. We had to get the patents going and the trademarks locally and internationally, because rolling papers are really a tobacco product originally. And all the big companies, like the 300-year-old companies, the biggest rolling paper company makes $1 billion a year. It's they're like the General Motors of rolling papers. They make everything. It makes exact top jobs and people are, you know, it's a French company, right near the border with Spain. And the next biggest company is on the other side of the border. It's an incredible thing to be a part of it. You know, we kind of have a way in because we got something cool and they like it, we got to protect it. So if we get some traction, I think we'll be a good target for licensing or acquisition. It's basically, I'm doing most of the stuff. I have a lot of partners. MJBA is a big marketing partner. I have a lot of attorneys. But I would say it's like me and my friend Al and 25 lawyers, basically. So we have a manufacturing agreement with a company in the Dominican Republic. The papers come from Europe, best papers in the world. They run perfectly. And we cut them in a package in the DR. We had started in Toronto. Couldn't do it in the U.S. because of the FDA. It was like a tricky, long process, and instead of standing around working that out, I just went to Toronto and did the whole thing. But it's competitive, and it is a day before, I think, without a doubt. So we used to have 3 people for $12 an hour in Toronto. Now we have 8 people for $12 a day in the Dominican Republic, and our capacity went from 24,000 a month to 100,000 a month. And we're working on machinery to make that all. So it's a big engineering thing, which is fun for me, and I'm enjoying that. But we have salespeople too. Right now, we're at a point where we've targeted basically about 15 geo locations. We started in Toronto, but now we're in Vancouver, Ottawa, Seattle, first time in Portland, Denver, LA, Las Vegas, San Francisco. We're kind of going that way. We have 50 people in New Orleans and Florida, New York, Massachusetts. So that's kind of a, and it's all cannabis. We're 100% focused on cannabis. Next year we'll go to Europe and go back. We went to Europe to learn all about this stuff. Came back here and kind of did it all. We're getting our margins down and our volume up, and it's a whole entrepreneurial trip that we're all on. We've got salespeople calling retailers. We've got social media going to do the B2C. We do a lot of events. We do trade shows. We met everybody 10 times already. I traveled so much less for years, but I can explain to people. I did go to 50 cities. I basically went to 10 cities 5 times each. And you know, that's what we're doing. You know, create some traction.